If you have a strong desire, you will attract the right guru. So what should we do in our daily life to attract the right guru?
Okay. You see, there are different pathways you can adopt. For example, once you are stirred up and you are serious and sincere, these are the first requirements, sincerity and perseverance. You must have both. So if you are sincere about your journey and you have the power of perseverance, because it's not an easy journey, it is a journey that may take a whole lifetime. So you must persevere. It's very important. You can see this in a beautiful story of Kathopanishad. This young boy, Nachiketa, was trying to understand the nature of reality. And this story says, okay, he was asking the god of death, Yama, what is underpinning to this reality? Why are we born again and again? But the reason why Yama was so impressed with the boy is because he showed two major attributes required for it to make spiritual progress. And these are Vivek and Vairagya. Vivek means basically have the discriminating power to know that this is just a temporary fad and this is long-term solution. Most of us do not have that ability. Look, all our lives are caught up by short-termism. What can I get tomorrow? What do I have to achieve tomorrow? What should I eat tomorrow? Where am I going for my holidays? So you're really looking very short-term. You're not looking for a resolution of human condition on a long-term basis. So if that is the case, you are going caught up. In fact, that is why majority of humanity, if you look at the human, because I watch them, I watch human beings passing by in the cars, in the roads, I look at their faces, I say, what are they worked up about? They want kind of a particular motivation regarding how they want to lead their lives. What is the next objective? They are so kind of fixated on that, they're so kind of, kind of wound up in that, they can't think of anything higher. I'm not blaming them. This is the nature of humanity. So most of us get, if you like, go in a cul-de-sac, get in a cocoon state and just live there and kind of just sort out ourselves. You decided on a particular identity for ourselves. I'm a father, I must look after my children. And you kind of follow through that identity and live your life like and die. Now, these are people who are short. Even though you want to live a long life with your family, this is still short-termism. So the first requirement is Vivek, which means think about it long-term, my friend, long-term. Is this resolving your human condition on a long-term basis or just kind of temporary thing that you adopt while you're in the, as a family man, etc.? First requirement is Vivek. Discriminate between what is long-term and what is short-term. Again, a beautiful thing, again in the Kathopanishad, kind of presents the same idea. It says two things present themselves to humanity. One is called Shreya, the other is called Prayer. Prayer means very pleasant, very pleasurable. So you're quite immediately attracted to it. You won't kind of chase after this. Majority of human beings, 99%, are just kind of in that particular state of mind. They're just attracted by things which are pleasurable. Prayer. But then, Nachiketa learns that the more important thing is Shreya. Not that it's temporarily useful, but that is beneficial long-term. This word Shreya means beneficial, not pleasurable, beneficial. Humanity cannot make the distinction. They just kind of caught up by being chasing after something is pleasurable, and forget about long-term resolution, Shreya, beneficial. So this is the first requirement, Vivek, Shreya and prayer, make the distinction. The second thing, again, this Nachiketa suggested was this. The king of death, Yama, was very naughty. He said, look, my boy, don't ask difficult questions. We are too young. Don't bother. We are so lovely. I feel so nice about you. I'll make you the king of the universe for 1,000 years. And you can marry all these beautiful princesses and all these dancing girls. You can marry them. And you get all the gold in the world. Now, I'll give you all that. Forget about asking this difficult question. I'm Yama. I can give you all the wealth in the world, all the power. And you can marry and enjoy life fully. Come on, my boy. And Nachiketa, I love this chap. Nachiketa said, oh Yama, keep your dancing girls and your chariots of gold to yourself. Give me the answer to my question. This is called Vairagya. Not getting attached to this kind of worldly ideas or worldly objectives, looking for a resolution at a deeper level. This is the second aspect. So Vivek and Vairagya are the two major tools. And there are others, but these two I suspect are the most important tools to adopt in your routine life for you. So you see, look, when you look at your own daily life, and ask yourself, what is my motivation? What am I doing next week? What am I doing today? How do I run my life? You'll soon see that you are very much working for a short-term resolution to your human condition rather than sorting yourself out long-term. Unless you shift your attention to long-term resolution, you cannot make true spiritual progress. This is the beautiful idea that comes out in the teachings of, say, the Kathopanishad.